Hi dear student, before it you have read about simple sentence, how to add two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence according to synthesis. First of all, you have read about synthesis, participle, and after then infinitive, after then nominative, absolute. So today I will tell you how to add two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence by using a preposition with a noun or a gerund. What is gerund? In verbs first form, add ing to make a gerund. So in this way, by using of a preposition or a noun or a gerund, we have to add two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence. You have to know in this chapter first of all that in every sentences there are two parts, there are two clause, one principal clause and second subordinate clause. In this topic you may find two sentences. One sentence is principal clause and second is subordinate clause. So in principal clause you have no any change. You have to know which sentence is principal clause and which sentence is subordinate clause. And after declaring that this sentence is principal clause and this sentence is subordinate clause, in principal clause you have no any changing, and in subordinate clause you have to change the verbs into gerund, and after gerund you have to write an appropriate preposition, a proper preposition, and after then verb into noun. For example, he worked hard, he won a prize. Here are two sentences. First sentence, he worked hard, and the second sentence, he won prize. In this sentence there are two clause, one principal clause and second subordinate clause. Here he won a prize called principal clause, and in this clause you have no any changing. And here here this sentence is called subordinate clause, and you have to change this subordinate clause verb into gerund, and before gerund you have to write an appropriate preposition. So this is principal clause, you have no any changing. He won a prize, and here this verb may be converted into gerund, work plus ing, gerund, and before that verb you have to add an appropriate preposition by. So he won a prize by working hard. And in second example, his house was searched. He was absent at the time. His house was searched. First sentence, he was absent at the time. Second sentence, you have to know, you have to declare in these sentences which is principal clause and which is subordinate clause. So you may find that this is principal clause and this is subordinate clause. So his house was searched, in this sentence you cannot change anything, and after then you may change in this sentence. So his house was searched, and after then you have to add an appropriate preposition in, and after then this verb's noun. His house was searched in his absence. come to the next example. I saw some pigeons with stick in their hands. And after that, other examples.
Being ill, This is principal class. We have no any changing. In spite of being ill, he went to school. In spite of being ill, he went to school. And come to the other examples. Here are also two clauses, principal clause, subordinate clause. So first of all, you have to write principal clause. I bought a book and after him preposition for 30 rupees. I bought a book for 30 rupees. Come to the other example. He heard the news. He heard the news. His father died. He fainted. Here are three sentences. He heard the news. His father died. He fainted. So first of all, it is subordinate clause, and you have to convert this verb into gerund, and after then before it preposition. On hearing the news of his father's, here you have to change this verb into noun. Died verb may be converted into noun death. On hearing the news of his father's death, he fainted. In this way, by using a preposition with a noun or gerund, we have to join, we have to add two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence. So you have to revise this video, and after then you will find an exercise which you have to solve. Thank you.